Hello friends, welcome to Free Grammar Lessons. In this lesson, we will discuss about gerunds. What they exactly are, why they are needed, and when can we use them. So let's get started. What is a gerund? When we use a verb in place of a noun, then it is called a gerund. Again I repeat, when we use a verb in place of a noun, then it is called a gerund. Now, how we can form a gerund? We add ing with verb's first form and use it as a noun. Remember this, verb's ing form can be used in two ways. First, gerund, and second, present participle form. In gerund, we use this form as a noun, while in present participle, we use it as a modifier or progressive verb. Discuss about progressive verbs in our other video. Let's understand about gerund now. In our discussion about subject and object video, we have discussed that in any sentence, subject can either be a noun or pronoun. It cannot have any other forms. For example, Kartik goes to swimming regularly. Here, Kartik, which is a subject, is a noun. Let's see one more example. He is the best cook in the world. Here, he, which is a subject, is a pronoun. Now, looking at the examples, we can say that subject can either be a noun or pronoun. Let's look into an interesting sentence example now. Swimming is good for health. Here, what is the subject? It is swimming. Is it a noun or pronoun? No, it's a verb. Then how we can use it as a subject? Because just now we understood that subject can only be a noun or pronoun because it no longer behaves as a verb now. It behaves as a noun now. And so it is called a gerund. Let's look into some more examples to make it clear. Writing is an exchange of idea. Here, writing is a gerund which acts as a subject in the sentence. Reading helps a lot in learning new things. Here, reading is a gerund which acts as a subject in the sentence. We looked one use of gerund, which is as a subject. Now, second use of gerund is as an object. And third is as a complement of verb to be. Let's look into example where we use gerund as an object. I love dancing. Here, dancing is a gerund which acts as an object in the sentence. Mark enjoys cooking a lot. Here, cooking is a gerund which acts as an object in the sentence. Let's look into one more example. That is a good painting. Here, painting is a gerund which acts as object in the sentence. Let's look into one more use of gerund. Gerund can be used as complement of verb to be. Now what are to be verbs? In present, it is, am, and are. And in past, it is was verb. Let's see examples of them. Kriti's favorite hobby is playing the piano. Here, playing is a gerund as it is used as a complement to the verb is, which is a to be form. Look into one more example. Competition is trying to do better than your opponent. Here, trying is a gerund as it is used as a complement to the verb is, which is a to be form. That's how we can use gerund as a complement of verb to be. That's all about gerund in this video. Let's quickly revise what we have learned in this lesson. Firstly, we discussed what exactly is a gerund. It is a verb which acts as a noun in the sentence and it is created by adding ing to verb's first form. Then we discussed about three different ways in which gerund can be used. First, they can act as a subject in the sentence. Second, they can act as an object in the sentence. And the third way is to use them as a complement of to be verb. That's all in this video. Thank you for watching the video. If you have any questions or suggestions, please write in the comment section. If you liked the video, please hit the like button. Do share the video so others can learn, and do subscribe to the channel to get regular updates about the course.